Hello once again, guys. Welcome back to yet more Let's Play Brutal Mario. Alright, in the last episode, we took on the four-room house, the Zarudo switch, and we also completed the skull ride. And now it's time for us to take on the mirror fort, which has a slight an interesting thing to it. Because if I press left, Mario is going to go right. If I press right, Mario is going to go left. So my control is to be mirrored, essentially. Anyway, let's go. You guys won't see it, but I'm going to have to make sure the button I press is the correct one. This feels so weird. Damn it. The controls for Mario have been changed, the left and right. Everything else is the same. So I'm gonna have to be careful how I do this. Flip. Why spin jump on him? Try spin jump on him, but. Right, there we go. Let's see if there's anything up there. Definitely not, probably. No, just death. Let's save it there. And jump. The cape does come in handy here. Right. Flip. Save it. It still feels so weird, because it's because I'm not used to it. So, it's because I'm not used to seeing controls like this. I mean, I could have easily done a little cheat and say, right, I'm gonna adjust the controls, so that way I don't notice it, but I haven't. The controls are still 100% the same. That was definitely weird. It's still going. Yes. Save state it. Another cape. We'll take the cape. I'm actually getting used to it now. Should probably be a problem near further on. The up and down is still the same, it's just left and right is different. So this feels easy enough to deal with. Cause I'm definitely used to controls now. With him and him. Thing down here. Right, there we go. The controls are definitely weird as heck, man. Weird as heck. And they're still the same. Still gotta press left or right. Left to go left. No, left to go right, and right to go left. If that makes any sense whatsoever, explain it to me sometime, if you don't mind. Flip. That way. Now go. Don't show me a thwomp and not expect me to spin jump on him. It's like spin jumping on thwomps. Right, run. No. Run. Avoid dry bones. Jump. Save state it. This is just a fort, so I'm in the clear here when it comes to finding the orb. That's close. Keep going. What would a boss battle look like this? We're about to find out though. Save it and end. No, the boss battle is still the same. Boom boom again. Don't know how I can beat him now. Save it. Right, save it here and hopefully when he comes down to attack Mario, I'll be ready. Flip! Very good. Like, now he's doing his... So thoughts, let's see here, and... That'll be it. But the coins are there, though. Somehow I can make this... Get up there now, but I'll just... Just get rid of him. I don't know. Hopefully there's nothing important up there. It's not as if I'm going to be able to get up there. I don't know. Hopefully it's not... You know, because hopefully it just takes me to that switch. Good. The Red Switch Palace. We're finally getting to activate a switch. Switch of some sort. This actually feels weird now that I've got back to all controls. One hit. Two. Still, this feels totally weird. I don't know why, it just does now. And three. Running over here. To hit two. Run back. Hit four, run back and hit one. Which of course is over there. So I've hit two to hit one. Which in turn is screws me up, so if I hit one just... If I hit one just now, I can't go any further. So if I hit two, which in turn means I have to hit... If I hit one just now, I can't hit two again, so I can't hit three. So I hit one, hit three, hit two, I have to switch two off. Switch two off. If I switch one on, I can run a pass like that. Hit four and get out. I'm still not used to this. If I'm honest, the fact that the controls are back to normal. The power of the red switch. You've pushed, will turn it in that into that, your progress will also be saved. I don't know why it's so weird for me to press left and Mario's gonna go left. And if I press right, Mario goes right. I don't know why that is suddenly so weird. I do not know. Anyway, Squawk's ride is next. Dun 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 dun. Press B. Something over here. What the heck's down here? So what the heck's up the top up there then? Press B. Press B B B B B. Press B B B B. Press B B B. For some reason, Squawk has the ability to carry Mario and Yoshi. Who knew that this little parrot was so strong? Next, we could do this. And then press R. But I'm not gonna take a hit. Right, go. Go, Mario, go. Down, 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 down. Avoid B. B1 and B2. And B3 and B4. Flip! I don't want to lose Yoshi. I like this Yoshi. No, we're not losing Yoshi. Not yet. We'll keep him for as long as humanly possible. Plus, Yoshi makes everything cool. And in fact, we can do this. We can go in here, because there's something here, isn't there? Another Yoshi coin. Double kill. Double kill. Not much else going on here. Still trying to get used to the controls again. Because that mirror fort did screw me over a little bit. The control has been different. Is there something down this way? I don't know. For some reason, Squawk makes the sound of Yoshi. Nice. Is this just like a... what's that called? A maze. There we go. Not much else is going on here, just floating down into the pipe. And we say goodbye to Squawks. But we're still keeping Yoshi though, which is good. Yay! I like that. Kinda figured that'd be a double X area. Maze Cave 1. Which takes its place in a ghost house. Okay. I don't want that. I know it takes place in a ghost house. So I've also got to find another exit in this place as well. No, I'm still not used to it. I go this way. I've got pipes. Pipes galore. So I push that over here. Lantern pushes that over to there. Which means I can go. Which means that happened. That happened. If I go up here. Time reset. Yeah, the time resets. Which is mighty helpful. Mighty helpful indeed. Push that along. I was hoping that would... can I push that over? No. I've kind of got an inkling why it's doing that. Because I've probably got something running that's screwing me over. Good, so I wanted to push this block over here, which will then let me go into there. Can I get out of this block anyway? No. It's taking me here. So if I go to the left one, that takes me... takes me to where? To the proper exit or somewhere else? That takes me to the proper exit. To Iggy the Crazy. So if I take the right path... takes me back here. So where does this path take me? It's a pipe to the exit there, which I can't reach by the looks of things. No, I can't. There's no way to get in it. Get in at it. Goal is trying to figure out how to get to there. So I run back here. The block goes down there. Could do something about that block being there. But nothing is springing to mind right now. Before I know, I need a fire flower or something. Let's get that block out of the way. Because it's two eyes, I'm just going to have to do this again. Jump, jump, jump. Push that down, down, down. Over, over, over. Over some more. Would it work? No. thought I could just push the box together and that would get rid of it. So bang bang. In the air. Celebrate. I just wonder about that fire flower now that was given. Would that destroy the crates? Sorry, Iggy, you're gonna have to wait. Back we go to Maze Cave 1. Take the fire flower. Because I want to use it, Mario. Good. No, that doesn't work. The book goes there. Something there. Should I get it? No, I actually can, okay. No. That was weird. No way he's doing that. I'm trying to get a decent run up at this. I'm hoping there's something there, because I know what I'm supposed to do. No, flip. Ah, flip. Go in there. Bang, bang. In there. And celebrate. Again. This time, let's fast forward it. And let's save it there, and I think we'll also end it here, guys. When we return, hopefully we'll have figured out where the second exit is in the Maze Cave, number one, and we'll also take on Iggy the Crazy. So as always, guys, a very big thank you for watching, and we'll see you later on for yet more Let's Play Brutal Mario. So bye for now, guys. It's been fun, if not a bit confusing.